Hi, it's Andrew Hunter from Plugin Results, and in this video, I want to highlight the new features that we've just added to Membersonic version 2.100. This is the list of new features. We've added integration with a new platform called JV Share. We've added a factory reset button for those individuals that want to delete all of their Membersonic database files and for a fresh installation. We have added reCAPTCHA on our free registration forms. We have added a feature for you to allow subscription members to be able to access past content after canceling. So up until a point in time, if they decide to cancel, their membership is still active, but they can only access all content that they were previously had access to. So any future content they don't get access to. And then finally, we've added an advanced optional feature called support updates functions, basically. And I'll cover exactly what that does in this video. So let's get started. JV Share is a new platform that operates much like JVZoo and Warrior Plus and so on. It's an affiliate-based platform that uses PayPal and Stripe to process the payments. So if you sell products online and you're looking for affiliates to promote your products, this is a good platform for you to be able to use to do that. And we've just added the integration, and it works much the same way as the other platforms. If I go to our demo site here, and first of all, go to General Settings and go to Affiliate Systems. You'll see you enter your secret key for JV Share in this field. You'll need this notification URL, and that goes into your product settings in JV Share, much like JVZoo operates, pretty much the same way. And then you go back to your dashboard and you edit your product. And you go to Affiliate Systems and you enter your product ID for JV Share and click Save, and that's it. So that's how the integration works. We'll create a separate video tutorial for this to walk you through exactly how it's done, but it follows the same process. If you've done it for one of the other platforms here, then doing it for JV Share should be a walk in the park for you. So that's feature number one. The next feature I want to show you, under General Settings, under Admin Settings, you'll see this big red area here where you can proceed to reset the factory settings. So basically what this does is clicking that button will permanently delete all of the database tables you have for Membersonic. So if you've got an existing site and you screwed something up, you can just come here and click that button, delete everything, and then do a fresh installation. It'll call up the setup wizard again to create your pages and all of that stuff. So that's an easy way to reset your settings so that you can start over if you need to. Now let's click on the redirect pages screen here. Under here you'll see optional settings. We have this section called optional settings, and under there we've added enable reCAPTCHA. So if you enter your reCAPTCHA secret key and your reCAPTCHA site key into these fields, you'll be able to create a reCAPTCHA option on your free registration forms. And that's great for making sure that bots aren't trying to register in your sites, and it's actually a real human being. So that was a request from some of our customers, and we've implemented that request. Now let's move on to past content after cancellation. So we'll go to our dashboard and we'll open up a membership level here. And under the membership settings, we've kind of consolidated all the optional settings under here. So show only future content. We had this feature before, but it was kind of buried under the content access screen. So we removed it from there and we put it all under this one section called optional settings. So we had this before where you could, if this was enabled, select this option when you run a publisher type subscription site where you do not want new members to have access to content published prior to their join date. Members will only be able to access content published on or after their membership join date. So we had that feature before. It's a little easier to find now. I'm sure some members didn't even know it existed. And we've added this new feature called Show Past Content After Cancellation. So select this option when you want members to have access to content published prior to their cancellation date. They will still be shown as a member to this level. However, any content published after the cancellation date will not be accessible. So that's a new feature that we've just added, and you can use that if you run a publisher style model and you want to be able to give members access to the content that they've purchased up until a point in time, but any future content after cancellation, they will not be able to access. Now, with this feature, we've added some additional fields within the member management screen for each individual profile. So if I click on a username here and I click Edit Membership Levels, you'll now see that we have these additional columns. Before, we just had a date column with the checkbox to activate somebody with a membership, or whether or not they did have an active membership, that box is checked. We've relabeled this as join date now, and we've added these two columns. The subscription renewal column, that's applicable to the new feature, which I'll cover shortly, but for the most part, for users that don't use that feature, you can always ignore this column. But this cancellation date column is important. It's tied to the past content after cancellation. So anytime a subscription is canceled, somebody's removed from a level, it records that date in this column. So you can actually now see when they joined and when they canceled each level. Now, the last new feature we've added is kind of an advanced optional feature. And we added this because it was a need in our own business for being able to set up our One Results membership site, where we've consolidated a lot of our products and we are now offering a yearly support program on those products. So we needed a feature to be able to automate that. And we've integrated this specifically with ThriveCart because that's the platform of our choice for processing payments. We will be adding this to the other platforms, but for now it only works on ThriveCart. So let me show you where that feature is. And I'm not going to go into a lot of detail on that because we'll cover that in another video. But under the ThriveCart settings here, if you use ThriveCart, you'll know where this is. It's normal integration for all products, and you enter the product ID in this field, the product name slash ID in the format of product slash X or bump slash X or upsell slash dash X, X representing the ThriveCart product ID number. But below this, you'll see we have this section called Enable Support slash Update Subscription Functions. This is a special feature unique to Membersonic designed for software sellers who want to control access to software download links after a support term expires. So if you don't sell products, software products, then you can ignore this feature. It doesn't apply to you. But if you sell WordPress plugins or themes or other software that you're using to release through Membersonic, then this is a useful feature because by enabling this, we now can enter a product ID in either the yearly or monthly fields. Personally, we set it up under yearly. And what this will do is after a year goes by, after the customer's purchased, the download link expires. And this integrates with ActivateWP, which we use for licensing our software, and also for RefreshWP, which we use for automated updates. And it'll automatically remove the download links, and it'll automatically remove the auto update feature. So customers must purchase a renewal for support and updates in order to regain access to the site. This kind of automates that process for us. So this is really an advanced feature. It's highly customized to Membersonic and a couple of our other products. And if you use those, then this might be something you'll want to consider. Otherwise, just ignore this function because it doesn't apply to you. So that's it. Those are the new features that we've just added. And we're continuing to look at ways that we can customize how content is released to customers. We've got some other things in the works in that area for expiring content. We've got drip feed functionality, but now we're going to look at adding expiring drip feed functionality and a few other things. So expect some cool new features coming to the next set of releases for MemberSonic over the next several months now that Alex is on board. So hope this video helps. We'll be adding some tutorials for each one of these functions into the knowledge base over the next week or so.